Thank you very much to the organizing committee to give us the opportunity to present our results of a comparative study of einkorn, emmer, corazon and modern wheat, and we will focus on agronomic performances. So on behalf of my colleagues, thank you very much. In fact, what we have done since 2016 is in fact it takes part of a research project AltraGrain, so more diversity in agriculture and food, opportunities for alternative cereals and pseudo-cereals in Flanders, in Belgium. We will focus this afternoon on the triticums, of course, and we will focus on einkorn, emmer and corazon. As you all know, the einkorn and emmer are in fact hulled at harvest, need to be de-hulled afterwards. So that is important to consider in the comparison with corazon. I have to focus on the fact also that our research program is funded by our University College of Ghent. AltraGrain is a whole chain approach, and we go together with all these colleagues involved. We focus on the cultivation, on the technological characteristics, on the nutritional value, and of course also on the economic feasibility. Economic feasibility and cultivation method will be part of the presentation. First, we move on to the cultivation technique and we focus on the results of 9 trials, which I will try to summarize. In fact, the main research question is, in fact, in which way can these alternative cereals be profitably cultivated in Flanders and form the part of the development of a short chain initiative. That is in fact the basic question. I must tell you that in fact in our approach in the last 2 years, of course, our approach was more in fact maximizing yields, because we are in a region where the yields are very high. In spring cultivation we have 6 to 7 tons per hectare and even more, and we have 10 to 11 tons per hectare for conventional wheat, and so we are in that competition. And we have been working a little bit in that direction. The tested varieties are here in this table, where you see so the einkorn, the emmers, the corazon, which we have compared every time with the modern wheat. And so I will not go into detail. You have the varieties, you have the mandatory, and the year in which they were tested. We did in 2016 comparative trials in spring cultivation, species and varieties. In 2017 we had in fact 3 different approaches, in fact a 4-factor trial, species, variety, seed density and nitrogen fertilization on 3 locations, also a low input trial, also a trial on an organic farm, and finally a winter cultivation with 2 factors, species and variety. You see here that the majority of our experiments were done at our research station Botelare, which is managed in fact a cooperation between the University College of Ghent, Hoogent, and the University of Ghent. And we also worked together with the Agricultural Research Center for Cereals. We were able to do trials in the western part of Flanders on a heavy clay soil, as well on loamy soils in the eastern part of Belgium. So 2016, in fact, a 2-factor species and variety on 3 locations, so 3 trials. And you see, in fact, that it was a quite intensive approach with 100 units of nitrogen in 2 fractions in the spring cultivation. And we had also, in fact, a quite intensive approach, a weed control, 1 to 2 times growth regulator, with this high nitrogen level, fungicides 2 times, because we were in 2016 in a very wet year and we had a lot of diseases on the field, as well as insecticides had to be applied, because we, on the one hand we had the aphids causing the barley yellow dwarf virus, so the symptoms are here with the leaves which color, so the red points of the leaves, and so also affects yield. And we had also problems with Lemasianella. Lemasianella is in fact the wheat leaf beetle, which causes damage on the leaves. So our observations for einkorn, it was the first time that we saw Einkorn on the field, and we saw this slow development. What is happening? I don't know it. And so we were looking at it, and we saw the slow development. We saw that in fact for the traditional leaf diseases there was a low so the triticum so the Einkorn S and monococcum, triticum monococcum, is quite resistant to a lot of leaf diseases. But we observed so the damage of the virus as well as the damage of the Lemasianella. In these tables, you will see the colors. When you move up to green, let's say that is a better evaluation of the variety. Eh? The lodging, of course, was a quite important problem for the Einkorn. You see here on the picture here, takes some problems. Also, there was one variety in which I observed for the first time alternaria on our fields. We had the fusarium in that variety, and we had also the alternaria. That is for Einkorn, and then we move on to emmer. In emmer, we had less lodging, which depending on the variety. And in fact, the harvesting was always possible. We had one variety with a difficulty of ripening at harvest. On the other hand, in fact, we had the traditional wheat leaf diseases, but not in a spectacular level. So it was we could manage. Okay. For Kamut, in fact, for Corazon, yeah, I must mention the Kamut, of course, is a trademark. We have heard all the information. And it's cultivated in an organic way. Nevertheless, Mrs. Simonetti gave us the variety to use in our research program. And I have to focus on the fact it is not done in conventional farming. But we could do it, and well, we had some not so good results because in this intensive approach we had quickly development. We have early lodging, but the variety gets up again. But you have some part of the straw who remains on the soil always. And then you have then quite some important disease development. So of yellow rust, powdery mildew, the yellow stripe rust, the virus infection, septoria. So quite high level of disease, even with two fungicide applications. Okay. Modern wheat, of course, that we used, the Thibault, is infected, in a moderate way, but has to be treated, so it is a conventional approach here. The lodging is, of course, an important feature, because there is no lodging in that variety on that nitrogen level. The yields are illustrated here of that three locations, and we see immediately, in fact, the Einkorn and the emmer had quite good yields, 4 to 5 tons, depending on the location. We have the location here in Tongeren in the red. You don't need really to consider it, because in 2016 that was a really disastrous year in some parts of Flanders with heavy, heavy rainfall, and we had on that trial an important problem in that case, and so that's why these yields are quite marginal for these ancient cereals. So that is for the first year. The second year, we went to a low input approach for species and variety. You see immediately that the nitrogen level was lower. We only went to 80 units of nitrogen. No growth regulator, no fungicide. It was a more easy year, in fact, for wheat cultivation, because we had a very dry season at that year. Very dry conditions, and the leaf diseases were very low at that moment. We only had powdery mildew, in fact, and minor septoria, very minor yellow rust, etc. We see this evaluation here again, and I know I'll not go into detail, but we see, in fact, almost the same things that we saw in 2016. Related to the Lemasianella in the Einkorn and the powdery mildew for the emmer varieties, different with different approaches. And so in that aspect, I have to remind you that you don't see Lemasianella in emmer. So that isn't that was interesting for us to see, eh? Because the lemma the Emmer varieties have hair on the leaves, small hair, and these lemma cyanella this doesn't like these larves and doesn't like to crawl on these leaves. Eh? So that was interesting to consider. Eh? Good. Then we have the yields. You have here, in fact, the yields in that table, column table. You see the yields of 2017 in blue, and you see also the yields of 2016. We can make the comparison, and we see immediately that, in fact, the level of the yield was lower in 2016 in these dry conditions. That was for Einkorn and Emmer, not for... Thus also for Corazon, but not for the conventional Thibault, the conventional modern wheat here at the site. Then we move on to, in fact, the Don concentrations. We were very interested, as we do a lot of projects on fusarium and on mycotoxins, desoxynivalenol. We wanted to know, do these ancient grains have a high or low level in Don? We saw in 2016 that the level was quite very low, below, let's say, the reference levels by the legislation, except for Corazon. Corazon in 2016 had a higher level because, of course, the high incidence of fusarium in that year. But in 2017, there was no... all objects had low levels. Huh? Okay. Then we have the winter cultivation. Of course, the slow development of the Einkorn. That is something that inspires us. Is it not necessary to use, in fact, some kinds of fertilization to improve, in fact, the performance? Also, we had some information that Emmer also was possible in winter cultivation in our condition. And then we did a trial with a quite also intensive approach. We compared the Einkorn and the Emmer with the modern wheat winter varieties, which are quite common in our conditions. Based on soil analyses, we used, in fact, 175 kilogram of nitrogen on that modern wheat. And we used lower levels, of course, on Einkorn and Emmer. Low, well, depending on how you interpret on the interpretation. For the rest, you see the weed control, growth regulator, fungicides, one application, and so also the insecticide. You see here some pictures of it. Of course, this high level of nitrogen for the Einkorn, it was too high. We have to admit it. Even very early, the 12th of June, we already saw on the lodging, which was important on the field. Here you see the spectacular growth of the Emmer wheat, besides the conventional wheat. Okay, and then we move on to the harvest, and we see here the picture of it. That was the day of harvesting, very late in the evening, and so here you see the Einkorn, which was very flat on the ground, and we see the Emmer. You see lodging, but it is still harvestable, okay? So that resulted in the following results. Yes, of course, for the Einkorn in blue here, you see the results of this winter trial, and you see with that level of nitrogen, you have an important lodging, and you have losses at the harvest, of course. That is not, you cannot prevent that in these conditions. And you see that, in fact, spring cultivation, the level of the yield is higher for Einkorn. For Emmer, on the other hand, we had very good results. We had about almost 6 tons per hectare that we had. But of course, you see then, when you look at this data and you compare it with the conventional wheat who had more than 10 tons, which is normal in our condition, You think, oh, this is quite high. But you must never forget, this Einkorn and Emmer have to be de-hulled. So then we lose about 35% of the yield after de-hulling. So we did another organic trial also in 2017. And so we went to an organic farm and we adapted, of course, the cultivation technique. We went to a higher amounts of seeds per square meter. And we used, in fact, a basis of organic slurry, pig and cow slurry. In fact, about 70 units of available nitrogen. We had this dry conditions 2017. And we made a little mistake in the sowing depth. So the depth of planting was a little bit too superficial. And that we saw in the fields, in fact, the results of that. And we had a slow emergence. And that is, of course, never good related to the weed control. We passed with a Flextine harrow three times. But nevertheless, we had to do a manual correction. We had to do seven people had to go on the field working for half a day to remove the weeds from our field trial, only for that limited surface. So I have to consider that, and that's the way how the crop was standing very close to the date of harvesting in organic circumstances. The lodging was quite important for Einkorn, and for Amer it was acceptable. But in fact, in terms of yield, these yields were not very spectacular. Of course, we have to take into account the circumstances which were not ideal. And we see that Einkorn and Amer had almost the same level in blue here, in the blue columns, and were quite lower than the Amer. The Corazon was, in fact, with this high wheat competition, impossible to harvest. So we had not data of that organic trial in that year. Conventional wheat, no lodging, and in fact, a higher level of yield. Then we move on to, in fact, the multi-factor trials, where we had species, variety, nitrogen level, with a high level and a low level. And also a high seed density and a low seed density. I will not go into detail on the cultivation technique. It was quite comparable to 2016. But I have to consider one thing, that in Tongeren, where we had that situation, we had a lot of weeds in the field because of the slow emergence and the competition with the weeds. And especially in Corazon, we had, in fact, this high competition, very high, and it was impossible to harvest. And we, for the rest of the trial, we applied a pre-harvest weed control with glyphosate. I know glyphosate, everybody is against glyphosate, but in some cases, you have to apply it, otherwise you cannot harvest. Then we move to some observations of powdery mildew and Lemasianella, and we saw, in fact, a little bit the same aspect that we have in the former year, the Kamut with quite some important powdery mildew.
You have to cut a little bit because...
Okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Two max time? 5 minutes, yes. I will move on. 2 minutes, yes. I go to the final aspect of my presentation, and that is, in fact, the economic part, where we... looked at the economic feasibility. We calculated, in fact, the costs of our cultivation compared with the modern wheat. And we have here, in fact, the big difference is the seed costs. At the moment, the seed cost is quite considerable for these variety, these species compared to the modern wheat, resulting in a higher cost. Also, the labor cost was calculated quite big, quite high, because we had the interpretation that we use for everything a contractor. When we calculate then for the minimum yield and the maximum yield, the cost in euro cent per kilogram, we see big difference between Einkorn, Amer and Corazon, and on the one hand, and modern wheat on the other hand. Modern wheat, where we all know that the actual prices is quite low. And of course, depending on the market position, you can even have a benefit. Eh? But you see at the moment the average commercial price of the floor, integral wheat floor, is still high for Corazon, for instance. Eh? And here you see that you have to also take into account the dehulling for Emmer and Einkorn, and that that increases, of course, the costs. And depending on the market, we have to consider that. I come to my conclusions. Einkorn has a slow development. It's very sensitive to lodging in the way we have tested it. I have to admit that. We have a low sensitivity to diseases, but it is, in our conditions, quite difficult to cultivate. The emmer wheat is, on the other hand, better for these parameters and can be cultivated. The Corazon was in our conditions, so on the majority of our trials, conventional farming was quite difficult to cultivate. Of course, we need more the approach of a low input of nitrogen, and we need for that more trials. Much lower yields strongly affect the profitability for the farmers, even with low input, and of course, depending on the price at the harvest, and Einkorn and Emmer need to be dehulled. My apologies for my time spending, and I thank you for everybody for the attention. And are there any more questions?
Thanks.